plastic bag, drifting through the wind, wanting to start again. Do you ever feel so paper thin, like a house of cards, one blow from caving in? Do you ever feel already buried deep, 6 feet under screens, but no one seems to hear a thing? Do you know that there's still a chance for you, 'cause there's a spark in you, you just gotta ignite the light and let it shine. Just on the night, like the 4th of July, 'cause baby you're a firework. Come on, show 'em what you're worth, make 'em go as you shoot across the sky. We've got a life to live.
Hello, everyone, and welcome. We are happy that you could join us today. My name is Mr. Thomas, English teacher and ACL of grade 11 and 12 English, ESL, and literacy support here at Agincourt Collegiate. I am honored to have the privilege of being the master of ceremonies for today's celebration of the accomplishments of our 2021 graduating students. We will begin today's program with O Canada, performed by the Agincourt Singers, 2018, conducted by Mr. Pinhorn and Miss Tulk O'Reilly, and the reading of the land acknowledgement, in English, by Yalini Vartharaja, and in French, by Sanya Nuratliak.
Nous reconnaissons que nous sommes accueillis sur les terres des Mississauga des Anishinaabe, de la Confédération Haudenosaunee et du Wendat. Nous voulons également reconnaître la pérennité de la présence des Premières Nations, du Métis et du Inuit.
We are very fortunate at Agincourt Collegiate to have the collaboration and strong support that we do from our TDSB trustee, Ms. Yalini Rajakula Singham, and our Superintendent of Education, Ms. Carrie Lynn Stadnick. We are happy to include in today's program messages to 2021 graduates from TDSB dignitaries and members of our provincial parliament.
Hello, bonjour, and congratulations, graduating class of 2021. This is a significant milestone, finishing high school in the era in which you have attended high school this last year is remarkable. You are remarkable, and I am so sorry that you are not able to celebrate this significant achievement in person. You are headed off to so many different places in the following year, but know one thing, we are headed to a far brighter and rosier future. This year has been nothing short of challenging and uncertain. I know there have been so many obstacles and difficulties along the way. It has been a roller coaster of a year. But here's what Chris Hadfield, a famous Canadian astronaut, had to say. Early success is a terrible teacher. You are essentially being rewarded for a lack of preparation. So when you find yourself in a situation where you must prepare, you can't do it. You don't know how. Good news, you do know how. You have been through a challenging secondary year and you have made it. You are the first graduating class who has had to make it through a pandemic in an entire year of learning so differently. I'm so proud of you, and I know that your parents are so proud of you. And I know it was but a few short years ago that your parents couldn't imagine how you would be going to junior kindergarten or how you would be finishing elementary school. And yet here you are, embarking on a future full of promise and light. Times like this are an opportunity to reflect on ourselves. And I believe that every challenge offers an opportunity for growth. To the staff, to the education workers, to the leaders out there who have helped prepare you for this important milestone, as Director of Education, I thank you, each and every one of you. You have contributed to the future of our city and our country, and you graduates are the best possible example of who we need to be in the future. Merci, je vous souhaite la bonne chance. Thank you, and congratulations again.
Graduating class of 2021,
you did it.
My name is Alexander Brown. I'm the chair of the Toronto District School Board. I know this year has been like no other, and that it's been hard on you, your family, and your communities. The pandemic has changed the way we learn, work, and live. However, despite these challenges, you've risen above it. And although it might seem hard to believe sometimes, you've continued to learn, engage, and actively take care of your health and those around you. It was a huge job, and you really should be proud of yourself and what you've accomplished. I'm proud of you. And you happen to be the first full year graduating class during the pandemic. I don't know exactly how you feel about that, but you should take great pleasure and joy in your graduation and in celebrating with your classmates. Regardless of how COVID-19 has impacted you and your families, I hope that you have had a lasting impact on your school, classmates, teachers, and communities, and that you've been able to have a positive impact on others at the Toronto District School Board. Whether you're moving on to middle school, secondary school, or to post-secondary opportunities, we are here today to recognize and celebrate your skills and abilities, your teamwork, your ideas, your contributions, your hard work, and your commitment. You've done a terrific job during a pandemic to get to this day, your graduation day. You will never forget this day or this year. So stay well, stay engaged, keep in touch, and good luck. On behalf of the Toronto District School Board, congratulations.
Hi, Agincourt. Congratulations to our grads. I know this isn't how we imagined celebrating you and all that you've accomplished. It's been an extremely tough past year and a half with so many interruptions, but you did it. And regardless of what you choose to do next, whether it's more school in university or college, whether you decide to take some time off, or whether you decide to go to work, whatever it may be, I just hope that you and your loved ones stay safe and we get to a place where our communities are healthy and strong once again. And I know high school can be a very tough time. It can be a time where you feel that you're not good enough or smart enough, but just remember, high school is just 4 or 5 years in a lifetime. And it is not the end, it is just the beginning. And please don't let your high school experience be what you think the next few years are gonna look like. The opportunities are endless and you are limitless. So just make sure your intentions are clear, you're making informed decisions, and you just work extra hard. And I do not have any doubt that Agincourt students, all of you, will be up to some amazing things in the years ahead. I wanna thank Principal Nam Wong, Vice Principal Sivaraja, and Vice Principal Santos, our office admin staff, our teachers, our support staff, and our caretaking team. Thank you for carrying our students through this pandemic and supporting them. We truly, truly appreciate all the hard work you've done. And to parents and guardians, I know it's been a very tough past year and a half with a lot of difficult situations at home and within the community. And I know we have a lot of essential service workers and frontline workers. And I just want to thank all of you for all the work you've done to keep our communities healthy and strong. I hope everyone stays safe and see you soon. Bye.
Hi, everyone. I want to give a huge shout out to the class of 2021. Congratulations on this incredible achievement, and I'm so proud of you. I truly believe we have the best and the brightest young people anywhere in the world right here in Ontario. Today, I join your friends and family in celebrating everything you've accomplished. It wasn't easy, and you've overcome so much, especially during this unprecedented time. But you've made it. Your hard work, your commitment, and countless hours studying has paid off. You should all be so proud of yourselves because we are proud of you. You're absolute champions. Once again, congratulations to the class of 2021.
Hello, everyone. As your Member of Parliament, I am truly honored to join you for this special celebration. Graduation is a time filled with pride and memories when we celebrate the end of one journey and the beginning of another. Graduates, joining you today virtually are some of the people who have been with you and for you through the good and the bad, and I'd like to take a moment to acknowledge them. Your parents and family members, your classmates and friends, your school administrators, your teachers. And as you trek on in this journey we call life, these people will continue to be with you. In ways you may not realize, your teachers have helped you determine who you are and how you think. Your friends may remain by your side or be a text message, email, or Snapchat away. Your parents and family members will continue to guide and support you, but also give you room to grow and mature as young adults. Life will take you to new places. You will meet new opportunities and faces. At times, you will feel passionate, content, and enthusiastic. And at other times, well, you might just think, my life really sucks. In his first victory speech, President Barack Obama said, "The road ahead will be long. Our climb will be steep. We may not get there in 1 year or even in one term, but I have never been more hopeful that we will get there." The US president was of course talking about the war in Iraq, the health of our planet, the economic crisis, but it is a message of perseverance, of hope, and of change that is universal. Obama earned the respect of others, regardless of their race, age, gender identity, sexuality, or social class. Through hard work and determination, he started off as a community organizer who believed he could make a difference. As a racialized person of color, he faced naysayers who said he would never become the US president. But he did. Obama earned the respect of others. Graduates, the reality is that life isn't always fair. What we can do, however, is to demonstrate our character and show that we merit respect. So I offer you a few things to remember. Number one, we must challenge the status quo. It is only by questioning the way things are, the things we know, and the things that we are taught that the world can change for the better. Number two, we must fuel our human thirst for learning and knowledge and strive to grow each and every day of our lives. Number three, we must protect the health of our planet. And this, I believe, is the greatest challenge of our generation. Number four, we must show that we care for and value others through our kindness and generosity. And finally, we must be resilient in the face of adversity. Graduates, this year has been difficult due to COVID-19, but here we are and we have made it thus far. Know that when we fall down and experience difficult times, we must get up and know that tomorrow is a new day and the sun will rise again. If you do all these things, grads, you will certainly respect yourself and earn the respect of others. Graduates, congratulations on this very important milestone in your life. As your federal member of parliament and as a former school board trustee, let me tell you how incredibly proud I am of your accomplishment. I wish you every success on your journey ahead. Best of luck and congratulations.
Our principal, Miss Mira Nam Wong, will now address our graduates. Then we will enjoy a musical interlude by the Agincourt Virtual Concert Choir, directed by Mr. Pinhorn.
Hello, Agincourt grads of 2021. I hope you can see the bright sign behind me that says congratulations to the grads of 2021. I'm going to try something a little bit different. I'm sitting right in front of the school and on Midland Avenue, and the cars are whizzing by. I hope that you can hear my voice, but you know what? I just wanted to be able to talk to you from the heart and tell you that these past 4 years have whizzed by, and it didn't help that your year was interrupted with this insanely crazy pandemic. But you know what? First of all, I want you to know that you hold a very special place in my heart. Because the day you stepped into ACI as a wide-eyed grade 9 freshman, I too entered Agincourt as a freshman principal. And together, we have experienced so much. We both developed new friendships. We had a lot of laughter in the hallways and in the classrooms and in the offices. You built memories. You gained confidence. And you learned a ton. All the same goes for me in the last 4 years. I hope that you are as proud of your accomplishments as I am of your contributions to our school. You have left an impression on me that makes me believe that the future is in good hands. And I do not want to linger about this pandemic. It was awful. And you guys got ripped off. I'm just going to say it. You were robbed of so many opportunities that you should have experienced in these 4 years, such as graduation, a prom, a banquet, a carnival. None of it was fair. And my heart does go out to you for having to end your high school days like this. But you know what? Through this whole thing, you have been resilient. You have endured and you are strong. And I know that you are going to move on to achieve so much more because of all the things that you have had to gone through and survive. Let me let that pass. Big truck. Please know that while you were trying to figure out life and while life was trying to figure you out, you could not have done this without the people that have loved you and supported you every step of the way. Please take some time to thank your mothers, your fathers, your siblings, your aunts and uncles, because they have always been on your side and encouraging you and supporting you. Please reflect on the teachers that have made a difference in these last 4 years, and you will look back to what they did for you and how they helped you mold you become you. I hope that you take some time to be thankful in your heart to all those support systems around you because they helped you reach this very important milestone. I see greatness ahead of this incredible group of resilient and talented young adults. Whether you pursue your passion in the arts, music, sports, in writing, building, using your voice, or just simply finding your rhythm or your niche, I hope you love your journey. Be kind, have compassion, stay optimistic, and keep that hope alive. I have no doubt that you will find success and leave your mark along the way. Congratulations, graduates. We are so proud of you. You are now officially Agincourt alumni. Please come back to visit, and best of luck in your future endeavors.
Thank you.
Before we begin the presentation of special awards, I would like to thank our community members, parents, staff, and alumni, whose enormous generosity to Agincourt Collegiate has benefited our students for many years. Thank you to members of the Scholarship Committee for your work in coordinating these awards. We would also like to extend our thanks and acknowledgement to our one and only retiree of 2021, David Lum, music teacher and department head, who retired in January 2021. Mr. Lum is with us today and will introduce our first group of special awards recipients.
Hello, everyone. I'm honored to be part of this program celebrating the graduating class of 2021. The first award is the Alumni Scholarship. The Alumni Scholarship is awarded to two outstanding graduating students for their scholarship, leadership, and participation in both the academic and co-curricular programs at Agincourt CI throughout their high school careers. The first recipient is Sonia Naredelyak. The second recipient is Angela Wu. The Business Studies Award is presented to an outstanding business student who demonstrates excellence and leadership in business classes and who is pursuing a business-based degree. It is given in honor of our former beloved colleague, Andy Chung. This year's recipient is Jessica Managara-Kumar. The Athletic Council Leadership Award is awarded to a student in appreciation of their contribution to the students and the school. This year's recipient is Justin Luo. The Agno Scholarship Award is donated annually by 12 female teachers who developed a strong friendship while teaching at Agincourt CI. This award is presented to a grade 12 female student who is proceeding to post-secondary education with an emphasis on college and who is not receiving any other award. This student possesses a positive attitude, extends herself generously in support of others, and exhibits kindness, loyalty, and a sense of humor. She always strives to do her best, and she places a high value on friendship and the enjoyment of life. This year's recipient is Kior Chian Lin. The Family Studies Award is presented to an outstanding family studies student who demonstrates excellence and passion in the area of family studies. This student has contributed to the area of family studies with outstanding creativity and dedication. This year's recipient is Aria Baptiste. The Music Parents Association Scholarship is given to an outstanding graduating music student who has contributed freely to the musical life of Agincourt Collegiate and is pursuing studies in preparation for a musical career. This year there are two recipients. The first is Alexander Guler. The second recipient is Vincent Poon. The Special Education Student Success Award is bestowed on a special education student who has demonstrated outstanding achievement in academics, community involvement, and leadership. This year's recipient is Gabriel Pangan. The staff scholarships are awarded to three worthy graduates who will proceed to a degree course in a Canadian university or college. This year's recipients are Jessica Lee Shu, Arij Malik, and Aniqua Tasin.
Hello, I am Ms. Smashnik, English teacher and ACL of grade 9 and grade 10 English, literacy support, and reading interventions. I'm honored to read the next group of award recipients. The Jean Campbell Outstanding ACI Citizen Award is given to a graduating student who, by participating in a variety of activities or clubs in a leadership capacity, has distinguished themselves as an excellent role model and mentor to other students and made a significant contribution to the life of others in the ACI community. Sammy Zhu. Canada and World Social Studies, Social Science and Humanities Scholarship. Presented to two graduating students who have demonstrated outstanding scholarship in multiple courses within the department, have contributed to the ACI community, and are planning to pursue a related degree at the university level. Alexander Guler, Jody Muthu. The Paul Ann Hoskins Memorial Scholarship is given to a student who is pursuing post-secondary studies in music at the university level. Lalaine Agpo. International Languages Scholarship, presented to a student who excels in international languages, Stephanie Sadaheo. The International Group Incorporated Science Scholarship is donated by the International Group Incorporated to a student who shows above average proficiency in three science courses, Sriya Rajam. The International Group Incorporated Mathematics Scholarship is donated by the International Group Incorporated to a student who shows above average proficiency in three mathematics courses, Miara Sanjayan. The Michael Kirkley Memorial Award. Michael Kirkley attended ACI from 1973 to 1978. He was an elite athlete who excelled in sports and drama. As Agincourt's star running back, he led the Lancers to win the 1975 Scarborough Junior Football Championships. He went on to Western University, where he also played football. In 1982, he was drafted first overall by the Toronto Argonauts, where he played two seasons before returning to Western to complete his degree. At Agincourt, Mike also played the lead role in the musical Sweet Charity, and was involved in many other activities and clubs. Through his competitive spirit and business prowess, he went on to found Market Force Communications. Tragically, Michael died in September 2002. His family donates this award annually to an ACI graduating student who excels academically in sports and in drama. Jasmine Choi.
Hello, I'm Ms. Cooper, phys ed teacher and ACL of Health and Physical Education and Drama. I'm honored to read the next group of award recipients. The Doris Lawrence Scholarship is given in memory of her father, C.F. Lawrence, a former principal of ACI from 1931 to 1949, to a student who is most likely to pursue a post-secondary degree in education. Congratulations, Ashley Ramchitar. The David McDonald Award is presented to two students with the highest standings in the Senior English Program. Congratulations, Ellen He and Gordon Lin. The Carmen Ma Memorial Scholarship is presented to a student who excels in mathematics. Congratulations, Jonathan Chang. The Christopher McAllister Memorial Scholarship, donated annually by the McAllister family in memory of Christopher McAllister, who graduated from ACI's French Immersion Program in 1993. Christopher loved English literature and was in the school play in his grade 13 year. He was also a member of the football and rugby teams. His brother Michael and sister Ashley graduated from ACI in 1994 and 2003 respectively. This award is presented to a student who excels in English and who is continuing on to post-secondary education. Congratulations, George Yanomori. The Ogden Funeral Homes Award is presented to two graduating students who are pursuing education in life sciences and who have demonstrated exemplary effort and achievement in their science courses. Congratulations, Renee Fung and Aswani Gaurashankar. The Ontario Music Educators Award is donated by the Music Department to a student who demonstrates outstanding leadership to Music Council activities. Congratulations, Jonathan Chang. The Ontario Principals Council Award is given by the Ontario Principals Council to a student for leadership in school. Congratulations, Aria Baptiste. The Marsha and Tamara Audie Memorial Award is given in loving memory of Marsha and Tamara Audie to the graduating female athlete who exhibits exceptional team spirit and who values fair play. Congratulations, Tiffany Zhang. The Reynolds Scholarship is a scholarship donated by the Reynolds family to a student who has achieved both academic and athletic excellence. The family hopes to continue a legacy of students overcoming systemic barriers to attain a higher level of education. Congratulations, Raquel Steele Saunders.
Hello, I'm Ms. Faircloth, Guidance Counselor in ACL of Business, Co-op, and Chisholm Programs. I'm honored to read the final group of special award recipients. The Asghar Ali Fellow Chartered Accountant Scholarship, donated by the Rotary Club of Agincourt in honor of Asghar Ali, awarded to a student who has been accepted to a post-secondary program of business studies. The student has demonstrated strong leadership and community involvement throughout their years at ACI. Congratulations, Brandon Sue. The Jean Campbell Health Sciences Scholarship, donated by the Rotary Club of Agincourt in honor of Jean Kennedy Campbell, ACI alum, community advocate, nurse, and first woman chair of a college in Ontario. Awarded to a student who has been accepted to a post-secondary program of studies in health sciences. The student has demonstrated strong leadership and community involvement throughout their years at ACI. Congratulations, Karun Savasan. The John Terrence Flanagan Scholarship, donated by the Rotary Club of Agincourt in memory of John Terrence Flanagan, a founding member of the Rotary Club of Agincourt, member of the Association of Professional Engineers of Ontario, Ordre des Ingénieurs du Québec, the Geological Association of Canada, and the Prospectus and Developers Association, awarded to a student who's been accepted to a university program of studies in engineering. The student has demonstrated strong leadership and community involvement throughout their years at ACI. Congratulations, Angela Law. The Doug Sinclair Memorial Award, awarded to a student who displays both aptitude and proficiency in the Technological Studies program. Congratulations, Angela Law. The SAC Award, presented by the SAC to a graduate who's been involved in student activities and who has maintained an above average grade. Congratulations, Aria Baptiste. The SAC President Award, given to the ACI Student Council President in appreciation of their contribution to the students and the school. Congratulations, Ellen He. Social Justice Trustee Award, granted to a student who demonstrates exemplary leadership and must have given extraordinary service in social justice issues contributing to their school community. The student engages others through action on the ideals of cultural diversity, interculturalism, equity, and social justice. Congratulations, Gabriel Pangan and Raquel Steele Saunders. The Pavlovsky Memorial Scholarship, donated by Gina Pavlovsky in memory of her late husband, who was killed in an accident while at work. Ms. Pavlovsky's oldest daughter had just started Agincourt Collegiate when this occurred. Kelsey went on to be involved in sports and music at ACI and graduated from Western University in 2020 on the Dean's List with a Bachelor of Science Honors specialization in biology. Her younger children, Andrew and Marissa, are currently students at ACI. Congratulations, Deneen Jarrett. And lastly, the Governor General of Canada Bronze Medallion. The Bronze Medallion is presented by the Government of Canada to the student who graduates with the highest standing in his or her class or school. Congratulations, Sriya Rajyam.
Congratulations to all of our special awards recipients. Before we acknowledge our diploma recipients, we will enjoy a musical interlude, We Rise Again, by the Agincourt Virtual Choir Ensemble, grades 11 and 12. In addition to their Ontario Secondary School Diploma, graduates may receive an Ontario Scholar designation and or a Specialist High Skill Major designation. A graduate receives the Ontario Scholar designation for achieving an average of 80% or above in six grade 12 courses. A specialist high skills major is a ministry-approved specialized program that allows students to focus their learning on a specific economic sector while meeting the requirements to graduate from secondary school. Agincourt Collegiate offers specialist high skills major in sports, business, manufacturing, and nonprofit. Ms. Cullen will now introduce the first group of 2021 diploma recipients.
Sarah Abdallah. Coltrane Abrams, Ontario Scholar. Omer Ahmad. Azealia Ahmed, Ontario Scholar. Tarane Alaguraja, Ontario Scholar. Rita Alakuzai. Trinity Ali, Ontario Scholar. Purani Amarasan Apathy. Nathara Agam Mena, Ontario Scholar. Ryan Ayud, Ontario Scholar. Arushan Arya Rathnam, Shizam Manufacturing. Kushai Ashmead, Ontario Scholar, Shizam Business. Maria Alexia Balamasida, Ontario Scholar. Aisha Bana. Aria Baptiste, Ontario Scholar. Christopher Bedeau, Ontario Scholar. Param Bhatt, Ontario Scholar. Stephen Bian, Ontario Scholar. Dorian Byron, Ontario Scholar. Basma Bouchafra, Ontario Scholar. Mariam Bougani. Eloise Kane, Ontario Scholar. Justin Campbell. Ivy Cho, Ontario Scholar. Kelly Cho, Ontario Scholar. Winnie Cho. Elizabeth Karandang, Ontario Scholar. Ali Senges, Ontario Scholar. Maggie Chan, Shizam Business. Tommy Chan, Shizam Sports. Andrea Chang, Shizam Nonprofit. Ryan Cho, Ontario Scholar. Gigi Cheng, Shizam Business. Amy Chen, Ontario Scholar, Shizam Business. Anika Chen, Ontario Scholar, Shizam Business. Dennis Chen, Everest Chen, Ontario Scholar. Henry Chen, Ontario Scholar. Jennifer Chen, Ontario Scholar. Gia Chen, Shizam Business. Sandra Chen, Ontario Scholar. Vicky Chen. Wenny Chen, Shizam Nonprofit. William Chen, Ontario Scholar. Yvonne Chen, Ontario Scholar. Zhishen Chen, Ontario Scholar. Henry Chang, Shizam Business. Jennifer Chang. Jonathan Chang, Ontario Scholar. Shirley Chung, Ontario Scholar, Shizam Nonprofit. Winnie Choi, Ontario Scholar. Jasmine Choi, Ontario Scholar. Alexia Christogiannis, Shizam Business. Jeremiah Chu. Anton Chua. Lily Chung, Chisholm, Business. Anissa Cease, Chisholm, Business. Janaya Coley, Ontario Scholar, Chisholm, Nonprofit. Alexander Deng, Ontario Scholar. Ryan Dingra, Ontario Scholar. Tyron Dinapu. Rhea Dinesh, Ontario Scholar. Rio Donald, Ontario Scholar. Raymond Duan, Ontario Scholar. Daniel Dunbar. Harrison Fraser, Ontario Scholar. Renee Fung, Ontario Scholar. Zita Gadam, Ontario Scholar. Nielsen Go, Ontario Scholar. Shu Go, Ontario Scholar. Justin Gomes. Serena Gordon, Chisholm Sports. Ashwani Gawishankar, Ontario Scholar. Nipan Grevo, Ontario Scholar. Hannah Growal, Ontario Scholar. Jan Ernest Guanco, Ontario Scholar. Alexander Goller, Ontario Scholar. Arnav Gupta. Congratulations to all of you. Mr. Pinhorn will read the names of the next group.
Edmund He, Chisholm Business. Ellen He, Ontario Scholar. Alan He Chen. Adam Helal. Matthew Ho, Ontario Scholar. David Hoang. Angel Hu, Chisholm Sports. Emily Huang, Ontario Scholar. Eric Huang, Ontario Scholar. Gordon Huang, Ontario Scholar. Mandy Huang, Ontario Scholar. Kira Hum, Ontario Scholar. Trevor Hum. Shukri Ibrahim, Chisholm Nonprofit. Danish Iqbal. Deneen Jarrett, Ontario Scholar. Aaron Jaswal, Ontario Scholar. Khadija Jatta, Ontario Scholar. Olivia G, Ontario Scholar. Jack Jiang, Ontario Scholar. Ryan Jing, Ontario Scholar. Mika Joseph, Ontario Scholar. Isabel Kadahar, Ontario Scholar. Ashwin Kanutarai. Varnia Kantharuban, Ontario Scholar. Georgia Kaputanakis, Ontario Scholar. Navithan Karalasingham, Chisholm Business. Arunan Karunathasan, Ontario Scholar, Chisholm Business. Saifullah Khalid. Hafsa Khan, Ontario Scholar. Maryam Khan, Ontario Scholar. Musa Khan. Saba Khan, Chisholm Business. Joshua Kim. Gabriella Kolo. Henry Kuang. Caitlin Kwan, Ontario Scholar. Brian Lam, Chisholm Business. Kaylee Lam, Chisholm Manufacturing. J. Joshua Lachada. Adrian Lau, Ontario Scholar. Angela Law, Chisholm Manufacturing. Jessica Li Shui, Ontario Scholar. Amanda Lee, Chisholm Nonprofit. Salman Lee. Matthew Leung, Ontario Scholar. Janet Leung, Ontario Scholar. Alchemy Lee, Ontario Scholar. Bernice Lee, Chisholm Business. Helen Lee, Ontario Scholar. Nancy Lee, Ontario Scholar. Simon Lee, Chisholm Manufacturing. Congratulations to all of you. Miss Young will now read the names of the next group of graduates.
True LeBird. Kevin Lima, Ontario Scholar. Angela Lin, Ontario Scholar. Gordon Lin, Ontario Scholar. Kerchan Lin, Ontario Scholar. William Lin. Guanhong Liu, Ontario Scholar. Jaden Liu, Ontario Scholar. Kyle Liu, Ontario Scholar. William Liu. Davian Low, Chisholm Business. Ganoush Logan Radra, Ontario Scholar. Connie Long, Chisholm Business. Alex Lozanov, Ontario Scholar, Chisholm Business. Melissa Liu, Ontario Scholar. Justin Liu, Chisholm Business. Sonia Liu, Ontario Scholar. Sierra McLeod, Chisholm Nonprofit. Areej Malik, Ontario Scholar. Kareem Malik. Jessica Manigarakumar, Chisholm Business. Mule Mao, Ontario Scholar, Chisholm Manufacturing. Arusa Mariam, Ontario Scholar. Preeti Mariana Yagam, Ontario Scholar. Subiksha Mathivathanan, Ontario Scholar. Mikhail McPherson. Andrew McHale. Zoe Milligan, Ontario Scholar. Miyazada Nasibola. Adriana Moe. Ashanika Mohana Thivan, Ontario Scholar. Ibrahim Murad, Ontario Scholar. Thrissa Murugathis, Ontario Scholar. Nora Mustafa, Ontario Scholar. Jody Muthu, Ontario Scholar. Ali Nadim. Akshaya Nagalendran, Ontario Scholar. Arman Nanji, Ontario Scholar. Sean Neji, Ontario Scholar. Sonia Naretlukjak, Ontario Scholar. Megan O, Ontario Scholar. Marianne U. Tracy U, Ontario Scholar. Jeremy Pacheco, Ontario Scholar. Gabriel Pangan, Ontario Scholar. Kamini Patel, Ontario Scholar. Chris Patel. Rhea Patel, Ontario Scholar. Kabanash Pavalaganthan, Ontario Scholar. Joshua Perez Clement. Amy Fegu, Ontario Scholar. Patricia Fan, Ontario Scholar. Vaughn Phillips, Ontario Scholar. Mackenzie Pong, Ontario Scholar. Vincent Poon, Ontario Scholar. Rachel Potter, Ontario Scholar. Rehan Prasdi, Ontario Scholar. Nikisha Premadas, Ontario Scholar. Marusha Premakanthan, Ontario Scholar. Congratulations to you all.
Ryan Quang, Ontario Scholar. Hassan Qureshi, Ontario Scholar. Mohammed Raisi. Preeti Rajanbabu. Sanjeev Rajiv, Ontario Scholar. Sriya Rajiam, Ontario Scholar. Ashley Ramcharitar, Ontario Scholar. Ben Rastin, Chisholm Sports. Savaruni Rathnayaki Mudiansalage. Darsha Ravindran, Ontario Scholar. Jaden Rowley. Nolan Ryan, Ontario Scholar. Karun Savasin, Ontario Scholar. Eric Sadik. Stephanie Sahadio, Ontario Scholar. Gia Sani, Chisholm Business. Mara Sanjayan, Ontario Scholar. Om Sath, Ontario Scholar. Nalavan Selvakumar, Ontario Scholar. Nada Shah, Ontario Scholar. Arvid Shao, Ontario Scholar. David Shao, Ontario Scholar. Meena Sharvananthan, Ontario Scholar. Cheyenne Shaikh, Chisholm Business. Siddhartha Shukla, Ontario Scholar. Samaya Siddika, Ontario Scholar. Valentina Sitt. Alicia Sivanason, Ontario Scholar. Anthony So, Ontario Scholar. Eric So, Chisholm Manufacturing. Yalini Sothi, Ontario Scholar. Tharaka Srikanthan, Ontario Scholar. Raquel Steele Saunders, Ontario Scholar. Talia Stewart, Chisholm Nonprofit. Vicky Sue, Ontario Scholar. Brandon Sa, Chisholm Business. Kevin Sun, Ontario Scholar. Denise Sai, Ontario Scholar. Maheen Saeed, Ontario Scholar. Isan Saeed. Anika Tassin, Ontario Scholar. Sabrina Tam, Ontario Scholar. Ivy Tan, Ontario Scholar. Victor Tan, Ontario Scholar. Adrian Tang. Daniel Tang, Ontario Scholar. Megan Tang, Ontario Scholar. Alicia Tatham. Tasia Taylor, Ontario Scholar. Brandon Teo. Praneeth Thevaraja. Nathan Thiruvarul, Ontario Scholar. Dylan Thompson, Ontario Scholar. Yassine Thompson. Daphne Tian, Ontario Scholar. Riva Timilsena, Ontario Scholar. Tiffany Tram, Ontario Scholar. Paige Sang, Ontario Scholar. Timothy Savolos. Congratulations to all of you. Ms. Vichich will read the names of the final group of diploma recipients.
Lalain Ugpo. Haroon Umar, Ontario Scholar. Keenan Ung, Ontario Scholar. Dayan Uthayakumar, Ontario Scholar. Sion Valentine, Ontario Scholar. Yalini Varatharaja. Usif Varvani, Ontario Scholar. Maya Vasquez, Chisholm Business. Nathisha Vijayakumar, Ontario Scholar. Skanthan Vijayaranjan, Ontario Scholar. Michelle Vong, Chisholm Nonprofit. Danny Wang. Eric Wang, Ontario Scholar. Fiona Wang, Ontario Scholar, Chisholm Manufacturing. Catherine Wang. Stephen Wang, Ontario Scholar. Winona Wei, Ontario Scholar. Jacob Weiser. Sierra Williams. Eric Wong, Ontario Scholar. Melody Wong, Ontario Scholar. Vanessa Wu, Ontario Scholar. Angela Wu, Ontario Scholar. Brian Wu, Chisholm Manufacturing. Janice Wu, Ontario Scholar. Helen Z, Ontario Scholar, Chisholm Nonprofit. Jeffrey Zuzang, Ontario Scholar. Jackie Yan, Ontario Scholar. Adam Yang, Ontario Scholar. Shauna Yang, Ontario Scholar. Aaron Yi, Ontario Scholar. Andrew Yim, Ontario Scholar. George Yanmori, Chisholm Nonprofit. Stephen Yu, Ontario Scholar. Winston Yu. Andy Zhang, Ontario Scholar. Jason Zhang, Chisholm Manufacturing. Kenichi Zhang. Tiffany Zhang, Ontario Scholar. Amador Zhao, Chisholm Business. Owen Zhao. Max Zhao, Chisholm Nonprofit. Johnny Zen, Chisholm Manufacturing. Ivan Zhang, Chisholm Business. Jackie Zong, Chisholm Manufacturing. Joyce Zong, Chisholm Manufacturing. David Zhu, Ontario Scholar. Peter Zhu, Ontario Scholar. Sammy Zhu, Chisholm Sports. Zoe Zhu, Chisholm Manufacturing. Jesse Zhu. Kevin Zhu, Ontario Scholar. Congratulations, grads.
Congratulations, graduates. It is now my honor to introduce this year's valedictorian, George Yanmori. I think George is the perfect valedictorian for this year. The 2020-2021 school year has been a year like no other. And George is like no other. It has been a year full of challenges, and George has faced many challenges. And it has been a year where we need perseverance, and George has definitely demonstrated the trait of perseverance. I first met George when he was auditioning for the variety show. It wasn't the greatest introduction. I didn't know it was George. He was wearing a latex unicorn mask he had purchased on sale at Party City, because who doesn't need a latex unicorn mask? He and a friend got up and played crazy guitar licks out of time to the music while bouncing around the pit of the auditorium. I had never been so confused at a variety show audition. He didn't get into the show that year. His band, Quadratic Formula, however, did get into the show in his grade 11 year, and he was in the show multiple times in his grade 12 year. My next encounter with George was when he came to show me a poem that he had written. I wasn't his teacher, but it had been suggested by other teachers that he come to me to get advice for his writing. So he did. And the poem was, strange. I tried to be encouraging and pointed out some things that I liked, but his sense of humor was definitely different Apparently, I was positive enough to encourage him to keep coming back, and he did keep coming back. And eventually, near the end of grade 10, he brought me a story that was good. Like, really good. I gave him some feedback and sent him on his way, and this time I actually hoped that he would be back in my classroom with more writing. And sure enough, that happened in grade 11. I had the honor of taking a group of students to some spoken word workshops with professional spoken word artists. And then I had the privilege of helping those students prepare their own spoken word poems. And of course, George was one of those students who signed up. When I heard George's poem, I knew he had a chance to win. We hosted a school contest, and the top three entrants from Agincourt moved on to the regional finals. In the regionals, George gave the best performance of his poem I had seen yet, feeding off the audience. And he advanced to the city finals, which were going to be broadcast live on CBC. I was so excited that I was going to go watch the live recording. This, however, was one of the first casualties of COVID. George didn't let COVID get him down, though. Though there were no board-wide spoken word workshops or initiatives this year, he decided to start his own and hosted a citywide virtual spoken word poetry contest. He also started a new Agincourt initiative, a website devoted to creative writing and art. It's called Lancer Voices, and if you haven't checked it out yet, you should. George found a way to bring the Agincourt community together in a year when everyone was forced to be apart. Every year, I encourage students to enter a board-wide short fiction contest. George entered this year and finished fifth in the board and was published in the booklet and on their website. Oh, and by the way, the story he submitted was a revised version of that story he first showed me back at the end of grade 10. And that's what makes George so great. It's not his accomplishments. It's his growth mindset. George could have gotten upset that he didn't get into the variety show the first year he auditioned and never tried again. Instead, he practiced harder, got better, and was a highlight of the show each of the next 2 years. He could have let lukewarm praise of a poem cause him to stop writing. He didn't. He kept at it. He constantly reworks his writing. Even when he is praised, he reworks it until it is just right. And because of that effort and constant tweaking, he ended up having incredible success in a spoken word contest and a short fiction contest. He could have let COVID ruin his grade 12 year. Instead, he had one of the most memorable years a student could have by paving his own path. Instead of complaining that his year was ruined, he started a website, ran a spoken word contest, and entered and was published in a writing contest. He made the most of the situation. And that's why he's a great candidate for valedictorian this year. George isn't your conventional candidate, but this wasn't a conventional year. And George demonstrated the creativity and perseverance that are such necessary qualities, not only to survive, but to thrive during the unexpected. There are also qualities that will help in all aspects of your lives. So without further ado, I would like to introduce your 2021 valedictorian, Mr. Quadratic Formula himself, George Yonemori.
Net of Being is a painting by visionary psychedelic artist Alex Gray. It depicts an infinite net of interconnected consciousness. As I sat down to write this speech, I couldn't help but think about how this painting captured exactly how I felt, not just about high school, but also my approach to life as a whole. I love this painting because it comforts me so much. It's a bastion of warmth in the cold darkness. I have one hanging in my room, another in my basement, and it's also my desktop wallpaper. Art is more about what you get out of it, not what the artist put into it. I love it because it reminds me that no matter how alone I may be or feel, I'm still always connected to something greater. No matter how disconnected we've felt this year from COVID-19, all of us graduating students are still connected. We're connected by our shared drive to succeed, our memories, both good and bad, and our resilience in the face of overwhelming odds. Hello, friends and family, students and staff. Hey, graduating class of 2021, It's not important how each of us got here, what courses we took, what grades we got, or what things we've accomplished. We all swim in different oceans, but we end up at the same shore. Pride should be the dominant emotion right now. We often hear about self-care, but we rarely consider that pandemic self-care is on a whole other level. We have to learn to celebrate the pedestrian things like maintaining a sleep schedule, exercising regularly, having a good diet, or just doing something that makes you happy. As for school, well, when the most exciting thing in a Zoom class is the leave call button, congratulations on making it to the end of a Zoom school year. That line was as much for teachers as it was for students. Special shoutouts to the teachers for doing all they do for us. Special shoutouts to everyone who still found ways to participate or facilitate extracurricular activities despite the impersonal environment, be it SAC, Agincourt Music, or Classical Literature Club. A very, very personal shoutout to everybody that submitted to the Lancer Voices this year. Special shout out to those who went above and beyond academically with things like AP classes or French. A heartfelt congratulations to each and every one of us graduates on reaching this destination. We didn't only climb this mountain, we climbed through a hurricane, thunderstorm, and blizzard all at once, and the mountain was made of glass. Broken glass. Yet here we are at the summit, together. I'm so very disappointed that I couldn't deliver this speech live. I'm disappointed we couldn't have commencement in person because of the big sick that's touched all of us. I'm disappointed we couldn't all be huddled together, sweating buckets in a torturously hot building, wearing uncomfortable clothes for an unbearable amount of time. It hurts me to talk about what we've all been robbed of. I'm truly disappointed. You see, there's always a silver lining to everything. You only need to choose to see it. And once you see the silver lining, learn how to embrace that negativity and turn it into positivity. For example, the first time I've ever had a poem published, it was about the stream of consciousness of somebody who is brutally failing a math test. Now, I wouldn't have been able to write "I actually failed" if I was the model math and science loving AP course taking chronically sleep deprived Agincourt student that I used to feel terrible about not being. I could not have had all the cool experiences I've had from having written that poem. I could not have created something that made so many people feel like they're not alone. Learn to dance with failure so you can make failure dance to your tune. Learn to laugh at yourself too, and absolutely stop comparing yourself to others, because wanting to be somebody else is a waste of who you already are. You are you for a reason, and you are here for a reason. So be you, and be here. In the words of the immortal comedian Bill Hicks, "The world is like a ride at an amusement park, and when you choose to go on it, you think it's real, because that's how powerful our minds are, and the ride goes up and down and round, and it has thrills and chills, and it's very brightly colored, and it's very loud. And it's fun. For a while." Some people have been on the ride for a long time, and they begin to question, is this real, or is this just a ride? And other people have remembered, and they come back to us, and they say, "Hey, don't worry, don't be afraid, ever. Because this is just a ride." But it doesn't matter, because it's just a ride. And we can change it anytime we want. It's only a choice. No effort, no worry, no job, no savings and money. Just a choice, right now, between fear and love. Bill Hicks, what a legend. But he's right. It is just a ride. High school too. And we choose what kind of ride it is for ourselves, and especially for each other. Remember that there is always a choice. Freedom is what you do with what has been done to you. I'm not going to tell you that there are going to be only sunshine and rainbows and $100 bills falling from the sky. The cyberpunk late-stage capitalist dystopia from the 80s is here, ahead of schedule, minus the neon and chrome. We're constantly exposed to aggressive advertising trying to get us to buy things we don't need. We're told we're not good enough, so we need to buy products, then more products, products made by people paid next to nothing. Another life lesson. You are not the things you own. Of course, every year is hotter than the last, and the ocean level keeps on rising. Racism and bigotry are still alive, and we must never forget those who have been victims of systemic abuse, such as the indigenous children that are being found in unmarked graves day after day. They say you can't move forward while looking backward, but I disagree. We learn history so we don't repeat it, and so those people's suffering wasn't for nothing. There's a lot of pain and suffering in the world, so what do we do about it? The first step is making sure the people in your day-to-day are okay. It doesn't take much time to check in on somebody. Building a bridge is always easier than building a wall. Sometimes being there for somebody is hard work, but nothing worth doing is easy. That's coming from a lot of experience. To save one life is to save the whole world. So be there for others.
It appears we've come to the end of our time together. I may not be able to see you right now, but know that I am deeply humbled and thankful you've chosen me to be your valedictorian over so many other great candidates. In summary, life is just a ride, and every day we choose what kind of ride it is. Whether or not we enjoy it is a choice too. Embrace yesterday's failure and turn it into today's success. Learn how to laugh at yourself and stop comparing yourself to others. Build bridges, not walls, and regardless of how different our paths are, remember that we are all connected as Agincourt graduates and as human beings. So let's get out there and change the world. Let's get out there and make some noise. And may our collective spirit never fade away. This has been Georgiana Mori, signing off. Thank you for everything. Good night.
Congratulations, class of 2021. You are now ACI alumni. Our very best wishes to all of you. Now we will enjoy a song, Not Goodbye, written, recorded, and produced by Jessica Mano Garakumar and Arij Malik, both of whom are graduates, class of 2021. That music will be followed by Somewhere Over the Rainbow, performed by the grade 11 and 12 AMR Strings class of 2020-2021.
Thank you.
Greetings, graduating class of 2021 from Agincourt Collegiate Institute. This is Jedi Master Mr. Richards, coming to you live from my, well, from my basement toy collection room. I'd like to congratulate you on a job well done. Magnificent accomplishment this year under extremely trying and difficult, challenging conditions. I wish you the best of luck in the future, and may the Force be with you always.
Agincourt Music Graduates of 2021, Mr. Pinhorn here wishing you a wonderful and great successful future and congratulations on your graduation. This isn't the ending that we wished for as music students and as your conductors, but you've done a wonderful job keeping our community a safe and beautiful place. All the best in the future, and we hope to see you in the flesh in our auditorium performing at an alumni event soon.
Congratulations, graduates. I'm so proud of you, and I wish for music students we could have had a last final concert together. Hopefully we'll still will in the future that we can spend some time here in the auditorium. We hope to welcome you back and see you again soon. Best wishes, best luck. We love you.
To the 2021 graduating class of Agincourt Collegiate, congratulations everyone. You made it through a very difficult and challenging couple of years, but your resiliency and your creativity are going to serve you well in your future endeavors. Congratulations once again, and all the best.
Hello, graduating class 2021. Mrs. O'Reilly here. Just wanted to take a second and say congratulations on your graduation. You made it through one of the most incredible years ever. To our music grads, we love you, we miss you. Wish we could have been together this year, but hopefully, fingers crossed, our paths will cross again very, very soon. Take care of yourselves, take care of each other, and remember, you always have a home here. We love ya.
Hey Lancers, big congratulations to all of the graduates of 2021. You have all shown tremendous strength and resiliency throughout this year, and we're so very proud of you and your accomplishments. Not just for what you did this year, but for all 4 years of your amazing time here at Agincourt. Thank you for your contributions and for everything you did to make this place as special as it is. Don't be strangers as you move on to this next amazing, wonderful chapter of your life. Please be sure to find your way home back to us. When it's safe to do so, please come and visit. Take care. Congratulations. Please stay in touch. We love you. Much respect.
Félicitations à mes 12e. Je suis tellement fière de vous. Vous avez travaillé très fort. Vous avez montré beaucoup d'adaptabilité, beaucoup de résilience pendant une année très difficile. Et je suis tellement désolée que vous avez manqué certaines choses, mais je sais que vous aurez beaucoup de succès au futur. Bonne chance.
Congratulations, class of 2021. You made it. This has been probably the most challenging year of my career. And I know it's been hard for a lot of you. You know, the shift from in-person to online learning, the loss of some of the sports and clubs and ensembles that you were a part of, it's been a real challenge. But one of the positives about facing challenges is that you build resilience and grit. And if you manage to be able to face what I think is probably the most challenging situation in educational history and come through it, you are well equipped to face your futures, no matter what they bring. And so I wish you all the best, whether you're heading off to university, college, work, or a gap year. I hope that you face your future challenges with the attitude that you can overcome them. Good luck.
Hello, Agincourt graduates. This is Ms. Walker. I want to wish you all the best in your future endeavors and great success in your post-secondary studies. You are an amazing and resilient group of students who will shine bright in all you do. Congratulations, class of 2020-2021. You did it.
Good evening, my ACI grads. Took you 4 years to get here. 4 years. 1.5 in isolation. Who would have thought you could have done school from your bedroom, from your living room, from your dining room? Still in bed, under the covers, with your laptop and your pajamas on. I know you're all laughing right now because you're all going, oh my gosh, that's exactly what I did. Listen, guys, I don't know what the future holds for you, nor I. But all I can say is I wish you all the best of luck in whatever you pursue in your future. And tonight is a special occasion. So congratulations to all of you, class of 2021. Congratulations, ACI grads.
Congratulations, class of 2021!
Woo! Hello, future! You did it! You're moving on up. Today we celebrating. We gon' turn it up. You made it. What an accomplishment. Put on your cap and gown and get ready. It's your graduation. It's your time, yeah. Yeah, you shine it. Congratulations. You deserve it. Yeah, you earned it.
Oh, oh. Walk across the stage, I'm feeling great.
I'm feeling great.
Might just do my dance and celebrate.
Celebrate, yeah.
Might just throw my cap up in the sky. Posing for these pictures, looking fly.
Write me down.
Cap and gown.
Yeah.
Might just wear this all day when I hit the town. My people cheering.
Yeah, I hear them.
They know how hard I work to get right here.
Yeah.
Today's a day I know I won't forget.
I won't forget it.
Can't wait to look back and reminisce.
I'm looking back.
Made it to a whole nother level. On the road to success with my toes on the pedal.
It's your graduation.
Graduation.
It's your time, yeah. It's your time. Yeah, you shining. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
You deserve it. Yeah, you earned it. It's your graduation. It's your time, yeah.
Time was well invested, confession,
confession.
From freshman to veteran, this here proved to be my best win.
First off, I just like to thank my mama. I like to thank God.
Mr. Beach, no.
You're moving on up. Today we celebrating. We gon' turn it up. You made it. What an accomplishment. Put on your cap and gown and get ready. It's your graduation.
It's your